Hello, I'm Mr. Anointed, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus, but hardly anybody knows. Turban and beard doesn't make you a Sikh. Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge. So most of these people with turban and beard, they call Nanak a guru. Guru means a rabbi, a Brahman guru. He was a Satguru. Satguru means Christ. They hardly know that Satguru stands for Christ. Never mind knowing. So Sikhi is not that cheap. One in a million will know be a Sikh. And two in 10 million. Same in Christianity. One in 1,000 will know gospel. And 2 in 10,000. So I am rendering exposition of St. John 1 verse 35 to 42, which I get it on DGO every day, a passage. The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples. Now John the Baptist, he was an ideal rabbi. He had disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural men through moral laws. But those who were being baptized by John the Baptist, they were Jewish men of age. Because when you are young, you do what your parents tell you to do. You have no other choice. But when you grow old, you know, then you start thinking yourself. And when you start thinking yourself, then they were going to John the Baptist. Because when they were young, they were told that you are Jew outwardly. But as they come to senses that Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self, then they went to John the Baptist to be baptized in the name of Abraham, to make them the sons of the Abraham, salt of the earth. The other day we had a lecture from a retired Archbishop Rowan Williams in Oxford University, and he talked about consciousness. He took the skin of the everything they could do, very brief skin, you know, he took the skin of the letters, but he did not know how you become salt of the earth. I asked him, how do you become salt of the earth? He had no idea. So they just, you know, have knowledge. They want to know, but unless God gave them, you can't have it. So salt of the earth are those people who are sons of their tribal fathers. So they have the shame, family shame. They won't do anything wrong which insult their family. So as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." You know, Jesus and John the Baptist, they were cousins. Not physically, spiritual one. Because both possess the very Spirit of God, Holy Spirit with capital S. John was to do the job of ideal rabbi, and Jesus was to do the other job of Christ, which is lead to resurrection. John's job was ideal rabbi, lead to ideal works, and works give you reincarnation. Whereas when you are become the son of the Most High through gospel, by understanding gospel, by preaching gospel from your mouth, that represents that you are the son of God, then you earn resurrection. You are never born again. So that death and birth cycle is gone. It's all by the grace of our Father we get resurrection. So here's the Lamb of God. The two disciples heard him say this and they followed Jesus. Now John the Baptist had disciples. Jesus had laborers. Disciples are once born, natural, men which are being disciplined through moral laws. In Jesus, you need to be sensible, not to be disciplined, but solitary of who have common sense. Common sense is Holy Spirit with small s, Spirit of man. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translates mean teacher, but of course they only knew Rabbi, you know, to start with. They did not know that he is a Messiah, the very Christ. "Where are you staying?" So they are, you know, they being starting the ministry. So they, most of the people called Jesus a rabbi, but he was not a rabbi. He is greater than a rabbi. Rabbis are moral teachers, and Christ is the spiritual preacher, preaching to your mind and not to your physical body, moral laws. John the Baptist was a rabbi, ideal rabbi. He was a teacher, not Jesus. He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. Now, they were a family of good people, because when Peter could not catch a fish, you know, he was like a little child confessing, "Oh, I must be a sinner, that's why I can't catch anything." That's what people think, you know, and they are not, things are not going their way. Oh, they say, I must be a sinner, you know, they are not going my way. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. No, it's not anointed, you know. Messiah means the royal priest of our Father God. Of course, he was anointed, mean begotten, first one who came to introduce. The second Messiah came in India in the name of Nanak. Messiah in India is called Satguru. So we have found the Messiah, which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John." You know, this tribal identity is important, because if you have tribal identity, then you are salt of the earth. If you lose your tribal identity, then you are worse than those born of the prostitute, devils. That's why Jesus, when he was in the temple was mostly people in the temple, they were of Judah tribe. They were very clever, they were, could read holy books and all that, memorize them, everything. So these Judah tribe people became being clever and well-versed in the holy books, then they were so popular that they became, their teaching become Judaism. And from Judaism, they become Jew. So that means from Judah tribe to Judaism is a spiritual from Jew. So a Jew is one who is inwardly, not this one Judah tribe. But soon, you know, they replace Judah tribe with Jew. You can't replace your father. So by replacing Judah tribe with Jew, they say bye-bye to their tribal father Judah. And when they say became bye-bye, then they become bastards, worse than those born of the prostitute. They are called super bastards, because they are spiritual bastards, not the physical one. Physical one, they are born of the legitimate parents. As Jesus stressed in verse John 8 verse 44, when he called them that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. They retorted, we are not born of illegitimate parents, we are not born of fornication, we are born of proper parents. That is, Jesus said, that's true, you know what you say. But when you became Jew outwardly, you renounced your Judah father knowingly. So you became a hypocrite of the first degree. And as you did the thing knowingly, so you committed blasphemy. And under blasphemy, now you became a Jew outwardly. And that is why when you said bye-bye to your tribal father, you became a bastard worse than those born of the prostitutes. So that's why you are super bastard fanatic devils. As today we have Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, of physical self, not of their heart. They are all of the same category. They are super bastard fanatic devils. That's why they are killing each other in Syria. Maybe same tribal people, some are Mohammedan, some are Christian, because they belong to different sect, you know, and they are killing each other. But if they know that they are same tribe, they won't kill each other. And we have the example I present that during partition of India, our village was in Pakistan area. So 2,000 people came to attack our village. And when my father told them that the headman invited my father and his brother to come out to explain certain thing, why people are gathered in your village. So my father went there with his brother. And when he went there, he told him, you know, a Sikh and a Muslim, their spiritual self inside, never born, never die. These tribal self are going to buy our born, they are going to die each other fighting. So when we tell that we are belong to Jat tribe and they were Aryan tribe. So if there's any enmity between our tribes, it's good time to settle. He said, there's no enmity, we are friends. And when my father explained everything, the hypocrisy of those three Lalas, Lala Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Lala Tara Singh Luhotra Khatri and Lala Gandhi, they were all shopkeepers. When he explained to him the hypocrisy of those, he told his 2,000 people to look after us as their guest. And he told my father, let's go to capital Lahore to stop this partition. My father said, it's too late. Let it go as it is, you know. It's not possible to stop it. So that is the power of gospel. So it's not for everyone unless you are twice born. And these people which Jesus picked, you know, most of them were sensible, twice born, looking for gospel, eager to know gospel. Whereas Peter was once born, but he was truthful. He was very religious, going to say prayer, fasting, everything will do as the rabbi will tell him to do. And for his clean heart, he was chosen, whereas Judah Iscariot of the Judah tribe, being clever, you know, he colluded with the temple priests and other people who were of Judah tribe, dominating Judah tribe. So he wanted to win their favors. He wanted to put hands in both. So that's why he deceived Jesus.